Here's a book, Some Thoughts on Ministerial Reshuffle in Ghana. That's the title of the book. Professor Aye did an excellent work together with the Ghana Academy of Arts and Sciences, Joseph R.A.I. So here we go. On page 11 of the book, you see it on your screen a little bit. It is about motivations for ministerial reshuffles. And it says that it's difficult to determine precisely the reasons behind ministerial reshuffles because in most cases, the reasons may not be made public. This situation, he says, had given vent to speculation and rumors. This is amply demonstrated in the dismissal of, and I've shaded that aside, Francis Poku as Minister for National Security in January 2008, according to Oboshi Saikofi. It says, according to Oboshi Saikofi, the then Minister for Information and National Orientation, this is what Oboshi said. If it became necessary for reasons to be given for Mr. Poku's removal, the president, being President Akufo, will do so. We cannot force the president to give the substantive reasons for his action. The president is strict and demands high standards from his officers. That's a quotation from the Daily Graphic in 2008. Now, this is the topic, promotion of government effectiveness and efficiency. It says one of the main reasons for reshuffle is to make the government more effective. Now, this is very important, and that's why we are thinking that at this stage, President Akufo Addo may need one. Promotion of government effectiveness and efficiency. One of the main reasons for reshuffle is to make the government more effective and efficient by either dropping non-performing ministers or preventing some of them from becoming stale in their positions. So this is important. The main reason for government effectiveness is that, Mr. President, please drop non-performing ministers. Mr. President, we are begging you, drop non-performing ministers. We have 2.5 years into the government. By now, we can make a determination, given that you have a minister for portfolio analysis. I'm talking about Minister Akutose. He is the evaluation minister, Minister for Evaluation. By now, the Minister for Evaluation and the President and the Chief of Staff should be able to determine who are the non-performing ministers. There has to be among 120 some people who are non-performing, given all what is happening. So dropping non-performing ministers or preventing some of them from becoming stale in their positions. In other words, reshuffles were based on correcting errors or dealing with perceived ministerial incompetence. That's very, very important. This is the professor's research. Actually, he's putting this out, and he's put this out a long time ago. He says that, in other words, reshuffles were based on correcting errors or dealing with perceived ministerial incompetence. Usually, non-performing ministers were demoted from high-profile positions to lesser ones, which may or may not be cabinet positions, or are dropped from the list. That's interesting. It says usually non-performing ministers were demoted from high-profile positions to lesser ones, which may or may not be cabinet positions, or are dropped from the list entirely. So I shared another part. Let's start from an example. An example is the reshuffle of September 30th, 1981. Under the Lehman administration, in this reshuffle, Mr. Joe Reindorf, the Attorney General and Minister of Justice, one of the most brilliant and successful lawyers in the country then, was sent to the Ministry of Local Government and Cooperatives because, in the words of Ohene, that's an author, the brilliant lawyer couldn't be transformed into a successful minister. It is sad to see Joe Reindorf go out of cabinet, but he himself must surely have been expecting it. The problem with brilliant people is that they tend not to be good team players, and their personal eccentricities must be nurtured and tolerated or not at all. Other examples of demotion of ministers through reshuffles include the so-called Phase 2 reshuffle of President J. Akufo in May 2006, in which Elizabeth Ohene and Charles Bintim, who were ministers of state for tertiary education. So that's Elizabeth Ohene being used as an example by Professor Achu Aye in the script. Okay, so Elizabeth Ohene, Charles Bintim were ministers of state and tertiary education and ministers for local government and rural development, respectively. They were reassigned responsibilities at the presidency as ministers of state. So that's an example of ministers who were taken out, not because they were not clever, but they were finding it difficult. In the same way, the book continues, equally hardworking junior ministers. That is also very important. And we are urging President Akufo Addo that if there are junior ministers, deputy ministers who are doing well, Maybe he should have a think about bringing them up to take up the real ministerial position, because it's all about a matter of competence and ability to discharge the duty for the ministry. So there's a deputy minister of finance who is doing well, and the minister of finance, maybe for some reason, is not doing that great. Maybe they should shift the deputy minister to the minister of finance. Well, President Akufo Addo has done that once in his administration. We all know that. But in the reshuffle that we think is due for him, maybe he should consider this aspect of the analysis as well. It says, in the same way, equally hardworking junior ministers were promoted ministers, while others were transferred to more appropriate portfolios to broaden their experience. For example, C.T. Nailanda, Ike Asare, and Ike Bensa, ministerial secretaries, deputy ministers at the Ministry of Interior, Ministry of Works and Housing, and Ministry of Finance, respectively became substantive ministers for education, labor and cooperatives, and social welfare, and works, respectively, in a general ministerial reshuffle in May 1957. That's a very long time ago. Similarly, Kofi Bako, Kweku Bako's father, Mr. Kofi Bako, a minister without portfolio, became the substantive minister for information and broadcasting when the new ministry was created in July 1957. That's still an example from the Nkrumah era. This is all about ministerial reshuffles. And we are saying, in our opinion tonight, that it's time for President Akufo Addo to do a reshuffle. This is the great Osagyefo, whose ministerial reshuffles we'll be talking about in the next few minutes. Some of them are very dramatic, and you will see Professor Achuayi write about them. Okay, let's get back to the script. It says that, Kofi Bako, minister without portfolio, became the substantive minister of information and broadcasting. In April 2006, Joe Gate, who is currently the minister for railway, as deputy attorney general and minister for justice, was elevated to the position of attorney general and minister for justice. President Kufuor in 2006 found that this minister, the one on your screen now, who is now minister for railway, who was a very hard-working deputy attorney general and doing very well as deputy attorney general, was elevated to the position of attorney general. That is what we are talking about. President Akufo Addo must identify those junior ministers, deputy ministers, who have evidence of having discharged the responsibility of the ministry. That's what President Akufo Addo did with Joe Gate. Joe Gate was elevated to the position of Minister of Justice. We go on and we'll see a bit more. His boss, that's Joe Gate's boss, Ayuki Otu, was dropped in a major reshuffle, which also affected J.H. Mensah, Yao Safo Mafo, Dan Boche, Kofi Kunedua Preku, Christine Churcher, Charles Bintim, and Isaac Edumaze, as respectively senior minister, ministers for education and sports, information, regional cooperation, and NEPAD, environment and science, local government and rural development, and central regional minister, all respectively. So that ministerial reshuffle dropped all of these people. There's another part the professor talks about. Redemption and enhancement of the public image of the government. This is reasons why ministerial reshuffle occurs. One of the reasons is that government be more efficient. The other one is this one. Redemption and enhancement of the public image of the government. Over the years, reshuffles have become antidotes for redeeming and enhancing the public image of the government after a scandal. Let's read that. Over the years, reshuffles have become antidotes for redeeming and enhancing the public image of the government after a scandal or scandals or rumors of scandals. I'm adding all that. Examples include the revocation of the appointment of Mr. Kroboy Dusei as Minister for Industries in April 1962 over his new residence, Asante House, which was taken over by the government, and purchase of a 3,000 gold bed by his wife. So this was a scandal. Minister Kroboy Dusei, the Minister for Industries under Nkrumah's regime, was found to have acquired a house in Roman Ridge called Asante House. The house also had a 3,000 pound gold bed by his wife. Because of this scandal, the Osagyefo removed him from government. And then the contractor who built the house, I'm still reading, Mr. E. Borio, was given a deportation order on the grounds that his presence in Ghana was not conducive to the public good. Daily Graphic, April 4, 1962. That's interesting. That's why I said Osagyefo's reshuffles could be dramatic. Kroboy Dusei was asked to leave. And the contractor who built the house also has to leave. This was about a scandal. Kroboy Dusei was, however, reinstated as Minister for Agriculture in September of the same year. No responses were given for his reinstatement. That's in Graphic, September 4, 1967. So, yes. So now we have laid the academic foundation for the reshuffle in the book that we are recommending to you to read. So why must President Akufo Addo have a reshuffle? We have identified two things. One, so that the government will realign in areas of competence and in areas of giving confidence to the people. There is another one, redemption and enhancement of the public image of the government. So these are the two reasons why we think it's time now, really, for the Akufo Addo administration to do a reshuffle. Well, it's time now for the president to conduct a reshuffle. The policies seem very good, very clever, well thought out. In policies, one district, one factory, one village, one dam, free SHS, planting for food and jobs. Those seem to be very good policies, innovative policies, revolutionary policies, and they are visionary. So Akufo Addo doesn't seem to, in our analysis, have a reason to conduct a cabinet reshuffle because of policy differences. No, the policies are clear. They are there. They are very good. Free SHS, one district, one factory, one village, one dam, planting for food and jobs, you know, a year of return for tourism. So fantastic policies. It's the implementation that's the problem. And the redemption and enhancement of the public image of the government is also one that is resonating very loudly. Okay, so with all of these bases set up now, let's have a look at Akufo Addo's cabinet. And you tell us whether you think, on the basis of the analysis, some of these ministers must either leave, be reshuffled, be retained, or they must stay. So there are two reasons that we are talking about. The first reason is the promotion of government effectiveness and efficiency. We talked about that. Two reasons why we think, in our opinion, Akufo Addo's government is due for a major cabinet reshuffle. Promotion of government effectiveness and efficiency. The other reason is the one that we talked about. It is the redemption and enhancement of the public image of the government. Redemption and enhancement of the public image of the government and promotion of government effectiveness. So, Minister number one, Foreign Minister Shelley Ayokobochi, what's your verdict? I don't know. You can send your stuff. Shelley Ayokobochi. Albert Kandapa, that's a touchy one. He's Minister for National Security. Let's get back to Albert Kandapa. Albert Kandapa is Minister for National Security. Well, what do you think? We have gone over Ayawaso West Wogon. We have had difficulties with police protection and internal policing. There has been some unnerving issues with national security matters. Well, we don't get the security report. You and I Ghanaians don't get it. But looking at it, maybe Albert Kandapa might need some help. Let's look at the next minister. Next minister here is the Honorable Mr. Alan Chemartin, the Minister for Trade. He has secured for Ghana the continental free trade hosting rights. For that reason alone, Alan Chemartin deserves applause. Alan Chemartin deserves to remain as the Minister for Trade and Industry. He has secured for Ghana the hosting of the Continental Free Trade. One of the major organizations under the African Union is going to be hosted in Ghana through the efforts of the Trade Ministry. Mr. Chemartin and his staff, congratulations. I don't think any reshuffle should shift Mr. Alan Chemartin. Who's next on our but if you think differently, you can tell us. Yeah, this one, the Minister for the Interior. The Honorable Lawyer, former Deputy Attorney General, actually former Minister of State and the Ministry of Justice, very distinguished lawyer, Ambrose Derry, Interior. We still don't have an IGP, and I don't know whether the police are working to the satisfaction of the Ghanaian people. Recently, the police themselves have been attacked. We don't get the security report, but, well, we'll leave the verdict to you. Next minister that we will see is the Honorable Samuel Atachia, very articulate Member of Parliament for Achimebuakwa. Samuel Atachia recently issued a statement in rebuttal to what people were calling corruption because he had awarded a contract. We had looked at it and it looked to us that the alarm was too early. Nothing yet had happened. Given his ambition and vision for Wexenhausen, we believe that Atachia should not be affected by any ministerial reshuffle. Congratulations, Leonard, Okay, let's see who is next on our list. And we selected our own list. So, Minister for Agric, planting for food and jobs has been successful. Rearing for food and jobs has been successful. Just the vision and his drive about this matter, his expertise in the industry, having cocoa under his sector. Cocoa used to be at the Ministry of Finance. Cocoa is now at the Ministry of Agric. And he has done well with conniving, He has done well with working with Ivory Coast to give Ghana and Ivory Coast a single platform in global cocoa discussion. Congratulations, Minister for Agric. He's one of the best. Next is Kojo Oponkroma as the Minister of Information. When you hear him speak, you know there's an intelligent man. He understands his communication. He was in the industry before. He's the only minister who has been promoted from deputy to minister within Kojo Oponkroma. He's doing a good job. Next is the Honorable Ken Oforiatta, Minister for Finance and Economic Planning. So far, the bond issue recently, the Minister of Finance explained, you know, Ghana organized a bond that was not successful, even though it was sold at 20%. Minister of Finance explained that it was successful. We are yet to actually interrogate the Minister of Finance's explanation. But of course, Ken, in his private life before he became minister, is very distinguished for his investment banking skills. As minister, we leave the verdict to you. Let's see who is next, because my good friend, John Peter Amewu of Adisadel College. Wow. He did an excellent job with the fight against Galamsey. He has been at energy. Since then, the lights have been going off. Yes, since Peter Amewu came in, the lights have been going off. I've not seen him to actually ask him what's happening. He's a hardworking guy. I don't know whether energy is a mouthful for him, but it just might be that perhaps Ministry of Energy is a mouthful for our good friend, John Peter Amewu. Mr. Amewu, have a good evening. Let's see who is next. Wow. The learned, distinguished Attorney General and Minister of Justice. The third lady in the line to hold the position for the country. Learned Attorney General and Minister of Justice. There was a release this evening when the rumors went around. His deputy, Mr. Penka, says that Attorney General is still at post. Yes, we know that she's still at post. But if there's a reshuffle, should Attorney General be moved? I don't know. Next minister is Madam Esla Owusu for managing the telco situation and actually being able to find telcos and get them to fix the problem and dealing with the telcos like she's working for the people of Ghana and being a very strong member of parliament. Strong woman, Madam Esla Owusu, deserves applause. I think that any reshuffle should keep Madam Esla Owusu at the Ministry of Communication. Honorable MP, thank you very much. You've done well. Whoa, free SHS. We know that free SHS is one of the flagship of the government, flagship programs of the government. This man has been leading it. He's member of parliament for Menchia as well. So as far as free SHS is concerned, NAPO has been doing an excellent job. If he should be moved, perhaps he should be moved to a ministry that also needs a bit of shake-up, interior and some of these places that need a very brutal shake-up. Maybe because of his energy, NAPO might have to. Free SHS looks like he's coasting quite nicely, and he seems to have a very competent deputy. So maybe NAPO might have to be given another area that needs a lot of shake-up. Excellent minister. Let's see the next. Wow. Professor Frimpong Boati, good evening. Not much to say. Let's have a look at the next one. And this is only our opinion, so you can. The sports minister, wow. We have to wait to see how the whole metamorphosis at the GFA turns out. The return from normalization committee to the football association committee. His only small matter was the bill that he presented to parliament when he came from Egypt, and it was almost ridiculed by every media house in terms of the itemized bill. We have not come back to that story, but that's the only low point. The Black Stars were not also able to do well in the tournament, but he didn't play for the Black Stars. He was only managing. Let's see how he manages the return from normalization committee to the Ghana Football Association. Thank you, Minister. This man has been very quiet. This man has been very quiet. But I think that given the huge tax at the Ministry of Defense, without any scandal from defense, no noise has come from defense, no soldiers have been rampaging, he has rather been cutting sword for doing the things that the soldiers want, building houses for them. For my money, Dominic Nitiwu is the best minister of the first 2.5 years of President Akufo Addo's government. I think that Dominic Nittu is the best minister. He has been able to handle defense so quietly. Nothing has been heard. Nothing has been said. Everything goes on smoothly. Graduations, whether it's staff college, whether it's military academy, changes of generals, promotions, everything has happened smoothly at the Ministry of Defense, which is a very difficult place to handle. Dominic Nittu, you have done a very, very good job. Okay. We have to be wrapping up and getting to the proper and talk about it. So that's our opinion on cabinet reshuffle. Our conclusion is that President Akufo Addo at this stage needs one, and he needs one urgently. Mr. President, please go ahead and give us a reshuffle. We have confidence in you. We think that your policies are great, but for two reasons, that promotion of government effectiveness and efficiency, that needs to be checked. The promotion of government effectiveness and efficiency, that needs some help. And also, the other one, which is the redemption and enhancement of the public image of the government. That's very, very important. For those two reasons, we think that you need a reshuffle.